This is indeed such a happy new year. I can see all the smiling faces. But somehow that smile disappears when you're called and asked to deliver a table topic. You have butterflies in your stomach?
Yes.
So today we are here just to have a discussion on how we can be better. The amazing speakers that you already are, how to be even more amazing, especially when it comes to delivering table topics. Now, have you seen a small child staring at his elder sibling at utter disbelief that how is he able to ride a bicycle without those two extra wheels? Have you seen a 5-year-old staring at his elder sibling? He thinks it's an impossible task. Maybe there is some magic behind it. And have you seen how gradually his father makes him ride the bicycle, the very same bicycle? He just removes the two wheels without letting him know, and there he is balancing himself. Have you seen another child who's thrown into the swimming pool and who has no idea about swimming? Parents do that?
Yes.
We have no idea about swimming, we are thrown there, and somehow magically this child learns to swim. Why does that happen? The child doesn't think much. He's there, he's thrown into it, and there, bang gone. He falls, he breaks his head, he breaks his knee, but he keeps trying and he learns. That's exactly what happens at Toastmasters. You might be a seasoned speaker, you might be a newcomer, you're called here, a topic is thrown towards you, and there you go. Without that, do you think we can be amazing speakers?
No.
Table topics is such an important aspect of Toastmasters, although it may seem frightening, but to me it is the most fun element of the meeting. Don't you agree?
Yes.
So let's see how we can make the most out of table topics. For the guests, let me just tell you briefly what is table topics. It's an impromptu session where you are called on stage, you're not aware of the topic, you're given an instant topic, you're given instant speech, instant applause, that's it. That's all about table topics. So now what, I'll give you the rule of the 5 P's. The first P is pick instantly. Now what happens is, the table topics master gives you a topic, and you have a little idea that is popping up in your mind, and then it's like, no, this is not good, I'll get something better and bigger. Has it happened?
Yes.
The problem is 99% of the times the bigger idea doesn't come, and that urge to get a bigger and better idea kind of spoils the tiny idea that was popping up, which would have sprouted into a beautiful speech. The first trick is to pick instantly on the idea that you have got. Your brain is smart. It will move towards the idea which will work good. I'm not saying that it's impossible to get a better idea. You might be lucky. You might get a better idea. But see, it's advice of seasoned Toastmasters to pick instantly, especially if you are a beginner to table topics. So suppose the topic is your favorite childhood memory. The first memory that comes to your mind, start speaking on that. Right? So the second trick that I would say is to personalize. Now if I had to give my educational session on just 1 minute, I would stick with just this one advice. Personalize. You have no idea how personalizing helps. Now what is personalizing? Personalizing is nothing but adding an anecdote, an incident, an experience from your own life where you make your speech yours. Then it's totally your speech. Suppose the topic is about happiness. Easy topic. Now I can go on and speak about what happiness means to different people, why we should be happy, and what are the things that make people happy. But if I come here and I am able to narrate an incident of my life, suppose the happiest days of my life, or what happiness means to me, or something like that, then that speech goes a notch higher. So the point is that personalize. You try to personalize. If you don't have an incident or an experience of your own life, it's okay. You might know some general story. You might know something that has happened to your friend, your family, your neighbor. You can steal that. See, when the topic comes, our mind goes and it tends to go towards something that we have already known. So it's always best to pick up on that and start speaking on something which is personalized. Personalizing is a great trick and will help you a lot. The third one is practice. have you been asked the question, how are you?
Yes.
Yes? Yes. Do you get nervous when you're asked the question, how are you?
No.
No.
Why? Because 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, you have been practicing to answer this question. How has your day been? Arey, we don't get nervous. You come here, I'll speak, how am I? How was my day? Because I'm practicing that. I'm accustomed to answering those questions. Similarly, if you're practicing table topics day in, day out, then it won't be something new and unfamiliar to you. You come here and it will become natural. The thing is that new Toastmasters need to practice even more. Now, especially when I'll go to the contest section, I'll speak about how practicing is important and what are the special techniques you can use for practice. Now, there's another technique which is used, which is the past, present and future. The past, present and future is you take the topic. I'm just sorry, but I think I have 15
10 minutes.
Okay.
So another technique is past, present and future. Now in this technique, what do you do is you take a topic, you speak something, think about it, and then you speak something about it in the past of your life or in general about the present and about the future. Now I'll give you two examples. The first one is, suppose the topic is about technology, social media, smartphones. You know, you could speak about what used to happen 20 years before, what is the scenario now, and how do you see it in the future. So if you know, it is suitable to certain kinds of topics, and if it is suitable to that, then you might as well use it. Another example which I can think of is if it is about courage, for example. So you can speak of an incident in the past of your life where you had, you know, exercised that courage and which helped you come here in the present. For example, joining Toastmasters. You know, giving your CC1 was an act of courage in the past. That is why you are in the present. And how in the future you hope to have more courage. This is another technique of past, present and future. Now the fifth one is play along. This is my favorite one. Play along means that I have asked you, what is your name? You need not tell me my name is so and so. You can tell me naam mein kya rakha hai. You can tell me what's there in a name. You can tell me names are temporary. The thing is that there is no direct answer to a table topics question. It is not a classroom textbook questions that have only one particular answer. We can go anywhere that we want, as long as it is connected to the topic, obviously. Although sometimes in the meetings, there are speakers who go way beyond the topic, it becomes humorous for us, and that's okay as long as it's in the meeting. So now play along, what can you do? First thing is, you think of certain quotes. You can have a list of quotes with you, which you can use in your TTs. Because most of the TTs are such that there can be certain quotes which are used along with them. You know, you could come here and you could just sing for maybe 10 seconds. It's playing along. You're playing along. You're not able to think of something. You sing along if you're able to think of something in that line. You're totally blank. You don't have a quote. You don't have a speech. Nothing. Ask questions from the audience. Yes, the audience will respond. What are you doing? You are buying yourself time to think about the speech. Okay, the second one is turning around the question. Suppose you don't know about the topic. The topic is your favorite music director in Bollywood. And you have not watched a single movie in Bollywood. You don't know anything about Bollywood. So what do? You come here and tell, I don't watch Bollywood, so please excuse me. No. Instead, you can catch on the keywords, music, Bollywood. Suppose in this case you don't know about Bollywood, but you know about music. You can speak about music and how you can speak of how music is limitless and how I personally don't want to limit music to just Bollywood. Why Bollywood? Go to Bollywood. You can play along with the topic. It's very much okay to do that, playing along with the topic. You know, another thing is, you can twist it. For example, the topic is, who's a better cricketer, Virat Kohli or Mahendra Singh Dhoni? Now, all the cricket lovers here, there are still people who exist who do not know anything about these two, although it might be shocking. Although after the exotic wedding in Italy, it's impossible not to know about Virat Kohli. But let's assume that you have no idea about them. There are topics which are informative and you don't know about them. So what to do in such a case? In such a case, again, you can twist it. For example, now, if you've been asked to compare two dignitaries, it's a hard comparison. That's something which we know. So we can either say, this comparison is something like comparing tea and coffee. The classic debate, which is better. Or this comparison is something like comparing prepared speeches to table topics. Both are different, both are unique, both have their pros and cons. And both are not competitors, but both work as a team. And that's why maybe both the cricketers work as a team to make our Team India proud. I didn't speak about the cricketing technique, about the cricketing style, about the history, nothing, because I didn't know it. But still I made a meaningful speech. So that's it. You just have to play along. You don't have to know everything. Your emotions, your feelings, your ideas, your opinions, your experiences are enough to answer the table topic, even if you're not aware of the answer fully. And the last one in playing along is being devil's advocate. Now, for example, you're called on stage and the topic is women are amazing drivers. And you are someone who doesn't believe in that. And just that very morning, you had a not so favorable experience with a woman driver, a fellow woman driver. You don't believe in women are amazing drivers. You don't need to. You can play the devil's advocate and you can tell here why you think women are not amazing drivers. So many people have that misconception that we have to stick to what's being told to us. You can twist it the way you want. You can speak against it. You can speak for it, against it, and then summarize it like in debates how we do it. You can go completely on a different tangent if it's related to the topic. So you can play along any way you want. You need not know the topic. Right? With no judgment to any women driver here. Now I'll come quickly to the newcomers. Now there are people who are very new to table topics. Or even if they speak in table topics, they have not yet been able to accomplish it that well as much as they want to. The first thing that I want to emphasize is please use the 30 seconds time in the meetings. The Toastmasters format explicitly says that you can have 30 seconds just to think about the topic. So in the meeting, you want to use, especially if you are a beginner. Because coming here and starting to speak instantly when you are not that confident.